السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, في سورة من سور القرآن سماها أهل التفسير بسورة النعم. In one of the surahs of the Quran, the scholars of tafsir chose the name النعم, the bounties, for this surah. Even so, the surah is called سورة النحل. Because in this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala names His bounties upon His creation. And subhanahu wa ta'ala, He makes it the criteria to request your uluhiyyah, your worship, your submission. كذلك وكذلك يتم نعمته عليكم لعلكم تسلمون. And thus Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completes His favors, His bounties upon you so that you submit to Him. And one of these bounties, brothers and sisters in Islam, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named in the surah, ni'matul bayt, the bounty of the house, the home. قال تعالى in the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the surah, وَاللَّهُ جَعَلَ لَكُم مِّن بُيُوتِكُمْ سَكَنًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made for you from your homes سكن, a place of rest, a place where you find peace, tranquility, serenity. I'm talking about your houses, your homes. Yes. That's the purpose of the house, where you find your rest, your home. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a lot of us do not see the house to be a bounty because somehow we got it, we have it. But walk into one of these busy cities like DC, New York, you will find so many people walking on the street carrying their belongings on a car. We call them homeless. They do not have a home. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the house is the place where you can enjoy in good, forbid evil. When we come out of our houses, somehow that duty, whether it is limited because you have no ground to tell people what to do, or you're going to find yourselves in harm's way if you tell them what to do, but in your homes, in your houses, you can change things. You can make a difference in your homes. You can flee actually from the fitan of the jungle outside. Yes, you can. وثبت هذا في حديث صحيح حديث معقل ابن يسار رضي الله عنه. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he spoke about the fitan, when he spoke about the tribulations and the trials of the last days, وَمَنْ نَجَاتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, where can we find salvation, O Messenger of Allah? He said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أَمْسِكْ عَلَيْكَ لِسَانَكَ, hold your tongue, وَلْيَسَعَكَ بَيْتُكَ, and make sure that you dwell in your house, وَبْكِ عَلَى خَطِيئَتِكَ, and cry over your sin. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the home is the place where the next generation is to be nourished, is to be brought up and prepared to deal with the challenges of staying as Muslims at these days. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما أخرج البخاري من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, كل مولود يولد على الفطرة, every child is born a Muslim. الفطرة هي الإسلام, is born a Muslim. And then the house, فأبواه يهودانه ينصرانه أو يمجسانه. The home, brothers and sisters in Islam, is the first brick, the first brick, the first labina, tuba, in the Muslim community. As if the home is the heart of the community. If the home is sound, the community will be sound. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I'm telling you, regardless of how comfy the outside is, if you do not find rest, if you do not find peace in your homes, you're never going to be at peace. You will never going to be at peace. Why do you go to work troubled? Why do we have problems in the masajid sometimes? I'm not talking about Abu Bakr, alhamdulillah. Because the brothers come to the masjid, they are escaping from homes. It's not a place of tranquility anymore. It is not a place of peace anymore. Brothers and sisters in Islam, because of this, because of the importance of that institution, the Muslim home, Islam instructed you what to do to have a Muslim home. You see, we, and I'm not here to sound pessimistic at all, but we really started a long time ago to do like the nations before us. The concept of أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْضِ. You just believe in some portions of the book and you disbelieve in others. This statement was made to the children of Israel. Because they pick and choose from the deen, the religion, what they want. Okay, I'm going to take this one. Oh, this one, no. It's a little bit hard. Oh, yeah, this one will do it. Religion is becoming like a color, like a fashion. يا إخوة في صحيح مسلم أمشرك مات سلمان الفارسي عبد الرحمن بن يزيد narrates this author رحمه الله. He says حكى لنا سلمان, سلمان the virgin told us that he met a mushrik one day. You know what the mushrik told سلمان? Your deen teaches you everything يا أخي, even how to go to the bathroom. What is this? قال نعم. Yes. Yes. Our religion, Islam, taught us how to relieve ourselves. We enter with our left feet. We make dua before we enter. We use our left hand cleaning our private areas. Yes. So you think Islam, brothers and sisters in Islam, disregarded how to construct a Muslim home, how to put together a Muslim home that serves the deen of Allah? You find a lot of Muslims these days talking about establishing the Sharia. Oh, is the Sharia, the Sharia. Go to their homes. Establish Sharia in your homes first. Establish Sharia in your Muslim institutions first before you fight non-Muslims to establish the Sharia, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Wallahu kalam, kalam gahawi, slogans. Establish the Sharia in your homes. You enter a Muslim home now, it is not a Muslim home. Pictures hanging in the walls. Even so, they hear so many times in the khutbas. A house that has pictures hanging in the walls, no angels. That means no mercy. And then the brother still complain, brother, I have jinn in my house. You have jinn in the house, but you dismiss the angels. Huh? When was the last time you prayed at home? As-salah ghayr al-maktuba. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do not turn your homes into graveyards, into cemeteries. Pray the salah other than the mandatory in your homes. Al-baytu alladhi tuqra'u fihi suratul al-baqara la yadkhuluhu ash-shaytan. When was the last time you recited surah al-baqara in your house and you complain? I cannot find peace. Shayateen is living in the house, ya akhi. And you complain? These shayateen get to your wives, get to your children, you end up fighting with one another. Brothers that bring their children into the masjid, they find the imam, music is haram. The imam waqif. This imam is, what is this? My father is playing music the whole day in the house. What is he talking about? Huh? Movies, love, romance, Allahul Musta'an, in the houses of the Muslims, in in the houses of the Muslims. Ya ikhwal, al-rajul alladhi yudakhin, a person who smokes does not smell his smoke. But the one who does not smoke smells it. When your son is 24/7 in the house watching movies that talks about dating, that talks about adultery, that talks about all type of things, al-qalb yastamri, the heart feel comfy with these concepts. Why our children are using profanity? Because this is what they hear in the houses, in the homes. Khalas, he's used. He said, if that, he's used to it because he hears it all the time at home. It's an issue, brothers, an issue, sisters, an issue. And we complain that you cannot imagine, and I'm not talking about this community, don't misunderstand me. I have phone calls that sisters call the police and their husbands for silly reasons. Silly reasons. I don't mind if your life is threatened because if your husband called the police and this is your only resort, call the police, no problem. To protect your lives, to save your life, no problem. In the Sharia, but silly reason. He did not buy me a purse. And I wanted to get to him. Boxing. And the brother, I'll divorce you. Brother, I divorced my wife 200 times. Does this divorce count? Ya Raji, 200 times later. ما هي مرة تكفي. هو انتقام. Vengeance. Our homes are becoming like this, brothers and sisters in Islam. That is why we're troubled. That is why we're not at peace. The houses are second. You go there, you find second. وَاللَّهُ جَعَلَ لَكُم مِّن بُيُوتِكُمْ سَكَنًا. Your spouse. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُم مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. Second. Second. Peace. Second يعني peace. Tranquility. You go there, you find peace. Brothers and sisters in Islam, like I said, the deen instructed you to how to put that house together. And he began with choosing the two partners. The two partners. The mates. The spouse. First of all, he addressed the man, because the man is the one who initiates the relationship. يقول له رب العالمين كما في سورة البقرة ولا تنكح المشركات حتى يؤمن. Dare you marry a mushrika? Dare you marry a woman who associates someone in worship with Allah until she believes? ولا أمة مؤمنة خير من مشركة ولو أعجبتكم. And a believing female servant of Allah, a believing slave, female servant of Allah, slave, Amma, is better than a mushrika, even if you like it, even if you like her. For the sisters, for the guardians of the women, وَلَا تُنْكِحُوا بِالضَّمْ وَلَا تُنْكِحُوا الْمُشْرِكِينَ حَتَّى يُؤْمِنُوا. Do not give your daughters in marriage to a mushrik until he believes. وَلَعَبْدٌ مُؤْمِنٌ خَيْرٌ مِّن مُشْرِكٍ وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكُمْ أُولَٰئِكَ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى النَّارِ. Those, they call you to the fire. They will take you to the fire. وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُو إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَالْمَغْفِرَةِ بِإِذْنِهِ. And Allah is calling you to Jannah. وَأَنْكِحُوا الْأَيَامَى مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّالِحِينَ مِنْ عِبَادِكُمْ وَإِمَائِكُمْ إِنْ يَكُونُوا فُقَرَاءَ يُغْنِهِمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. And marry the righteous from amongst you. Even if they are poor, Allah can provide for them. وَالسُنَّةُ تُبَيِّنْ يَا إِخْوَةِ. The Sunnah explains. That is the beauty of the Quran and the Sunnah, twins together. هذا قرآن أهو السنة. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كما أخرج البخاري ومسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه تنكح المرأة لأربع. A woman is asked in marriage because of four things, four reasons, four incentives. Her physical beauty, one, her physical beauty, she is beautiful physically. Her wealth, because she is rich. Her lineage, because she has a prestigious family, and because of her deen, because of her religion. Four. Which one, Ya Rasulullah, should I go for? Which one, Ya Rasulullah, should I go for? Ifar. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not say marry. He said win. As if they are very few. Nisa as-salihat al-an, ya ikhwa, very few, because the Muslim homes are not producing. Very few. You hardly find a righteous woman. You hardly find a righteous woman who does the work of Allah for Allah. Fadfar, win. The one with the religion. Taribat yadak. Why, brothers and sisters in Islam? يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما أخرج مسلم الدنيا متاع. This dunya is an enjoyment. وخير متاعها المرأة الصالحة. And the best of its enjoyment is a righteous woman having a righteous wife. هذه الزيادة في النسائي سنن أبي عبد الرحمن. إذا نظرت إليها أسرتك. If you look at her, she will please you. Our Muslim sisters right now, she's at home like a soldier. When she goes out, she put the makeup on. For who? You're supposed to beautify yourself for your husband at home, not for the people in the street. That is why he's looking around to the others, because he's not seeing anything at home. If he looks at her, she pleases him. And if he tells her what to do, she obeys him. وَإِذَا أَمَرَهَا أَطَاعَتْ وَإِذَا أَقْسَمَ عَلَيْهَا أَبَرَّتْ. And if he takes an oath on her, she will not make him fail his oath. المسلم الآن يقول والله لو رحت لبيت أبوك لم طلقي. طب والله لاني رايح. If you go, by Allah, if you go to this house, I will divorce you right away. I'm going right now. وَإِذَا غَابَ عَنْهَا حَفِظَتْ. And if you're not around the house, she will safeguard her chastity. حَفِظَتْكَ فِي نَفْسِهَا وَمَالِكَ. And she will safeguard your wealth. I don't want to sound like these people try to make this, oh, look at the Muslims, they always anti-women and anti-stuff. Ya Raja, get a life, anti-stuff. Look at this. Why a sister does this? Why a sister does this? Why? في صحيح ابن حبان بسند حسن حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. Listen to this. إذا صلت المرأة خمسها. If a woman prays her five, وصامت شهرها, and she fasts her month, وحفصنت فرجها, and she keeps herself chaste, وأطاعت زوجها, and she obeys her husband. Imagine this, sisters. Imagine this. You're not doing this for the husband. You're doing this for you. In the day of resurrection, you will be asked. There are 8 gates of Jannah. 8 gates. Right here. Which one you want to choose to enter Jannah from? انت بتعمل ايه عشان الراجل ما ينحرق بجاز الراجل اعمل ايه عشان الجنه. You do it for Jannah, not for the man. Not for the man, for Jannah. The incentive is Jannah. Brothers and sisters in Islam. فهذه المرأة يعني قصة لعلكم تعرفونها. A story that you may know, all of you. I'm really positive. It's a very famous story. But I'm going to narrate it quickly just for one ma'na, one meaning only from the story. Umar ibn Khattab, as we know, Amir al-Mu'mineen, he used to walk around Medina to check on his ra'iyya, to check on his qawm, to check on his people. Somebody hungry, somebody poor, somebody needing help. He got tired. كان معه زيد بن أسلم sitting with him. So he sat next to a wall, next to a house, يعني. And he heard this conversation. A mother and her daughter. الأم tells her daughter, I want you to mix the milk with water so that we can have more milk, so we can make more money. The daughter tells her mother, إِنَّ أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نَهَى عَنْ ذَلِكَ. The commander of the faithful, Umar, banned us from doing this. The mother tells her daughter, أمير المؤمنين مش معنا. إنه ليس معنا. أمير المؤمنين is not here with us. Where is أمير المؤمنين? He is not here. Sayyidina Umar hears the conversation from outside. قالت ولكن الله معنا. But Allah is with us. Umar, الحق. Mark the house, يا زيد. He rushes home, wakes up his children. By Allah, if no one of you marries this girl, I will marry her. In أحد الروايات. اظفر. اظفر. أهو. يعني هناك حديث، الحديث في سندي ضعف. من تزوج امرأة لعزها زاده الله ذلا أورثه الله ذلا ومن تزوجها لمالها أورثه الله فقرا ومن تزوجها لجمالها أورثه الله دمامة. If you marry a woman just for her wealth, Allah will make you inherit poverty. If you marry a woman just for her lineage, Allah will humiliate you. And on and on. الحديث ضعيف. Weak chain of narration. فسيدنا عمر right away. عاصم. أنا أتزوجها يا أبي. I will marry her, my father. You know, يا إخوة, هذه المرأة هي جدة عمر بن عبد العزيز. عشان just to let you know the impact. Righteous husband plus righteous wife. Righteous children. That's what you need. As you want to get to Jannah. You want a mate who can help you, a spouse who can help you make it to Jannah. That's what you want. So you want a religious woman, a woman with the deen. So when you tell her, قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, she will say, I hear and obey. Ya ikhwa, I have some sisters who complain about their husbands going to the masjid. My husband wakes up to pray tahajjud at night and he does not feel healthy during the day. Ya ukhti, ma tkhalli al-rajul yu'bid rabba. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu inna min azwajikum wa awladikum aduwan lakum fahdaruhum. Brothers and sisters in Islam, likewise you, likewise the sisters also, they were commanded to marry righteous people, righteous husbands, righteous spouses. Hadith fi Sunan al-Tirmidhi, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, إذا جاءكم من ترضون خلقه ودينه فزوجوه إلا تفعلوا تكن فتنة في الأرض وفساد عريض. If you have a daughter and someone comes asking you her in marriage and you are pleased with his deen, religion, and his manners, character. Don't go just for the character. Don't go just for the manners. Ad-deenu hakim. Sisters, sometimes they call, my husband is doing this and this and this to me, a sheikh. What can I do? I ask her, does your husband pray 5 times? No. I'm sorry. Go call the cops on him. I cannot help him. Because what I'm going to do, I'm an imam. I'm going to tell him, Allah said, the messenger said, if doesn't click with him, I really have nothing to help you. The father now, with sacrifice a righteous husband for a rich dude because he has the money. Al-Hasan ibn Ali radiallahu anhuma, a man came to him asking him, a group of youth are interested, a couple, 3, 4 of them are interested in marrying my daughter. قال زوجها من التقي. Make sure that you give her to a righteous person. فإنه إن أحبها أكرمها وإن كرهها لا يظلمها. If he loves her, he will basically place her in a good, noble position. أكرمها يعني. But if he hates her, he will never commit injustice against her. Because he fears Allah. التقي fears Allah. Because he knows the punishment. He knows what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says. And again, brothers and sisters in Islam, as-sunnah wal-Quran was-seerah is filled with examples. When Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam went to Madian, and the righteous man there found him righteous, pious, he actually asked him, إني أريد أن أنكحك إحدى ابنتي هاتين. I want you to marry one of my daughters. Why? Because his righteousness and piety. A brother who's poor, doesn't have whole a lot. But subhanallah, he's like a pigeon in the masjid. Hamamat al masjid. Comes to me, I'm interested in this sister. The father, he doesn't have anything. I mean, ya rajul tawakkal ala Allah ya sheikh. Al-arzaq biyadillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mafahim ya ikhwa. Mafahim al-dinya lakhabit. لخبيط يعني سعيد بن المسيب رحمه الله وهو من التابعين the son of the خليفة الوليد ابن عبد الملك came asking his daughter, he refused. No, in one of the wording of this story, julid, he was flogged for this. Julid. Because he refused the son of the Khalif. And at the end of a day, he given her in marriage to Abu Wada'ah, one of his students, for 2 dinar dowry. 2 dinar. Like $5 now. أمثلة كثيرة. عمر بن الخطاب. عمر بن الخطاب. كما في البخاري. لما تأيمت حفصة. He went to Uthman. He went to Abu Bakr, and at the end, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam married her. Oh, why? Why are they doing this? Why, brothers and sisters in Islam? Because those are the two partners. Those are the partners who will be responsible for the Muslim home. Quite frankly, and again, I don't want to sound pessimist at all. 75%, and this is like my own made up ratio, okay? I did not do any work here. 75% of the Muslims who are currently married right now, they did not marry on the basis of the religion. I assure you. He married because, oh, she's beautiful. Oh, he's handsome. MashaAllah. The religion is not even in the picture. ما كانت الدين أصلا في الموضوع خالص. Oh. And that is why we're having miserable homes. And that is why the divorce rate is so high. Every six, and this is a thought out number, and it's not my number. Every 6 minutes in the Muslim world, there is one divorce. Every 6 minutes. Why? Because we never really married our spouses on the basis of the religion. We never did. We married on other bases. And normally what happens is we married for other reasons, and then along the way, one of them, Allah casts light into his heart, he turns into the deen, the other one fights him. What are you doing? You're too fanatic. That's too much. Too much. Let's be modern Muslims. Modern Muslims. Lay, this is too much. وهكذا. Brothers and sisters in Islam, أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. First of all, I did not mean to come out today and just sound pessimistic, like I always said. I said it already 3 times, as if I'm really doing it. Nor I want to say that things are really bad. That is not the attitude of a believer whatsoever. يعني في صحيح مسلم يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من قال هلك الناس فهو أهلكهم وفي الضبط الآخر وهو أهلكهم. Whoever says, oh, people are destroyed, things are bad, he is the destroyed one. And I hope not to be one of those. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. Rather, I wanted to help my brothers and sisters in Islam recognize the problem that we have. We have a problem in our homes. We do have a problem, a big problem. And like they say, recognizing and seeing the problem is the first step towards solution. And I really wanted to bring this up because, alhamdulillah, in this community, I see a lot of youth in the khutbah. And I'm pretty positive that a great number of them is not married yet. And I wanted to make sure that they get the message that regardless of how long they wait, don't go for any other sister but a religious one. A one with the religion. Don't. And I don't want also my brothers who are married to leave today with the impression that they made the wrong mistake and they go home and divorce their wives. This is not what I meant either. I think something can be done. And this is the intention behind my khutbah, to be a start for another khutbah, hopefully next week, inshallah, next Jum'ah, where I will offer some solutions for an existing Muslim family. How can we reform our homes? How can we make them Muslim homes? How can we have a home that will produce the next generation, inshallah? And this is the intention behind my khutbah today, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Allahumma ighfir lana dunubana wa israfana fi amrina وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا، وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا، وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا، واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير، واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم إن أردت فتنة بقوم فتوفنا إليك غير مفتونين يا رب العالمين. اللهم أحينا بالإسلام وأمتنا عليه يا رب العالمين. أقول ما تسمعون، واستغفر الله لي ولكم، وأقم الصلاة.